Time to beat the heat, Halifax Humane Society's spay program for cats. Hi, I'm Wendy Jackson with the City of Deltona, and welcome to Best Friends on Four Legs. Each February, Halifax Humane Society sponsors a program to spay cats called Beat the Heat. My guest today is Amber Marco, the Community Outreach Director with Halifax. Thanks for joining me, Amber.
Thanks for having me.
Today we're going to talk a little bit about the importance of spaying your kitten cat, and also some about your program that you have coming up.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit about the importance of pet owners and spaying, the spaying process?
Sure. The decision to spay or neuter your animal is also always very important. It's the single best decision for long-term welfare of your animal. It helps to reduce the number of homeless pets, and a lot of the communities, what defines a homeless animal. Homeless animals are not just the offspring from other homeless animals. They're the offspring of family pets and purebreds that maybe don't have the ability to house that animal and bring it to us. So it'll help to reduce the number of those homeless animals by ensuring that the animals are not reproducing.
We should, I guess, like explain a little bit about the relationship the city has with Halifax. Our officers, when they collect animals, either via trap or just running at large, we take them to Halifax usually in the afternoon to see if they can be checked out, and then hopefully if their owner's not found, that you guys can adopt them out.
Absolutely.
So that's why our connection to Halifax is so important.
Absolutely.
Tell me a bit more about how spaying and even neutering improves your pet's overall health.
Sure. Overall, it's going to improve the lifespan of your animal. According to some statistics, USA Today notes that pets who live in states with highest spay and neutering also live the longest. So male neutered dogs live 18% longer than unmaled neutered dogs, and while females live 23% longer. In Mississippi, there was a statistic done where the lowest ranked longevity of animals was 44% of dogs that were not spayed and neutered. Statistics do actually show that spaying and neutering has your animal live or allows your animal to live longer.
Does it help with like keeping them close to home or help with their wandering off?
So it does reduce unruly behavior with the animal. So unneutered dogs are more assertive and more prone to urine marking, and it reduces the urine marking or stops it altogether. So it does that unruly behavior that animals have, that does reduce that. Unneutered cats, it urges them to not spray in an intact cat. And then spay or neutered animals by 4 months of age are allowed, or we can spay or neuter our cats by four months of age. It solves about 90% of marking issues, and it minimizes that urge to roam, the howling, and fighting other males. So it is something that definitely has shown that it will reduce roaming.
I know we get a lot of comments on Facebook when we post like that an unaltered male is like out loose or whatever. There's always these comments, well, they should have them,
spaying or neutering your animal does reduce the roaming.
So tell me some more about if I treat my cat or dog, can I expect to reduce their vet visits or the cost I'm paying for their overall care?
It absolutely does save on cost. The factor in the long-term cost of an unaltered pet are very clear. Caring for your pet's reproductive system, whether it be cancer or pyometria, can run up to thousands of dollars. Those costs can be exponential.
Because you're talking surgeries at that point,
right? Absolutely. So those numbers are much larger compared to the cost, especially with a clinic. And we do have a promotion that we'll chat about. But spaying or neutering, the cost of that is very minimal compared to what it could cost with surgeries and whatnot for your animal. Unaltered pets can be more destructive and high strung around other dogs. So those costs of serious fighting or vet costs related to a dog that's much more unruly can be much larger than the small cost of what right. it can be to go to a clinic and have your pet spayed or neutered.
So residents that live in Deltona are required to get a pet license with us mm-hmm. just to help track them or whatever. Is there mm-hmm. a reduction ever for someone that has taken the steps to have their pet spayed or neutered?
Yeah, so renewing your pet's license can be more expensive too. Many counties have spay or neuter laws that require them to be sterilized and require people with unaltered pets to pay a higher license renewal fee. So that is a lower cost as well.
We instituted about a year ago here mm-hmm. A trap, neuter, return, or TNR program. Mm-hmm. And it's run through our animal control office, but we rely heavily on volunteers, like when the cats are picked up or trapped, for right. them to take them to get care.
Right.
Tell me a little bit about your experience with TNR.
Sure. So trap, neuter, release. Cats are trapped. Like it's basically like it. It's
yeah. In ours, so. We have people that have personal traps, and then we have
correct.
City traps. And
correct.
If a resident has a problem with a nuisance cat,
sure.
we will come out and set a trap in their area if
correct.
We have them available. But
there are traps out yeah. there. Yep. And once they're trapped, they're taken to the vet or in some cases a clinic or whatnot to have them neutered and vaccinated. And it's really important to have them vaccinated so that they get the rabies shots that they need. But then also, once we trap them, we also return them to their community. So returning to their home or colony outside. And then we take the ones that are able to be socialized, and we do try to adopt those out because those are cats that are friendlier and it would be good fit for a home.
And there's a special marking they get, right, when they do go through the TNR process?
So typically they'll ear tip them so that once they're trapped and spayed or neutered, other, you know, if they're
our
found
officers
again,
know they belong to a colony or something like
correct.
That. What's the overall goal of a program like
sure.
TNR?
Sure. So the overall goal of TNR is to stabilize those feral colonies and to end the reproduction of more feral animals. We do remove the socialized cats from the colonies, but then over time it'll slowly diminish them, whereas we won't completely take them out. It'll just end the reproduction of the colonies. There was a study done by the University of Florida over 11 years with campus cats, and over the 11 years there was a decline by 66% just by using the TNR program. No new kittens were brought into the colony in the first 4 years, so it did slowly decrease the population of the campus cats by the 66% just by doing the TNR, the trap neuter release program.
So I guess we need some better education, I think, for residents who a little cat or kitten shows up at their back door and they
sure.
just decide they feel sorry for it, they're gonna feed it. Is that something they should be doing, or what's the responsible thing to do?
For the trap, I would definitely recommend calling, you know, your animal control officer if you feel that the animal may be a house cat that might be lost. However, if you believe it's a feral or it's an animal that lives outside, it's an outdoor animal, and it's not spayed or neutered, I would recommend calling maybe the Humane Society to see if there's a way that we can get a trap
and
put
out
there.
And it's difficult to tell whether it's been spayed or neutered, right? You have to get pretty close in detail with the cat to
correct.
Find out.
So it would be something, I mean, typically if there's an ear tipping that
right.
the cat may or may not be already spayed or neutered, but definitely calling the folks in the different areas that can help the animal control and Humane Society.
Does TNR improve the life of a cat, like, would you say, or?
Yeah, so I would definitely say that it improves cats' lives. It relieves the cats of the constant stress of mating and pregnancy. That can have a lot
because cats get pregnant very frequently, right?
Absolutely, so that stress can cause them to have their own emotional stress. Mating behaviors will cease. So roaming, like we had talked about, yowling, spraying, and fighting are all things that could decrease with a spay or neuter. Cats' physical health improves, so their coat, the condition of their coat will improve or should improve, and then they typically gain more weight when they're spayed or neutered, so they'll be healthier and more fit, and then it'll help them live healthy, long lives.
Are there other benefits that the TNR program brings to communities like Deltona?
Sure, it'll stabilize our population, so there's no new kittens coming around. And it'll also help them become better neighbors. If their relationships with the residents improve because they're not yowling and they're not spraying, their behaviors will improve. There's less calls to the authorities, and it'll boost their public image. People will look at cats as friendlier instead of looking at them as you know, a different, the way we're looking at them when they're not spayed or neutered. They may be, you know, yowling or spraying, and generally the public has that negative image of them.
And we have a Commissioner Heidi Hirschberg. She's very pro on this TNR program, but she's also expressed, like, over time we should see a reduction in funds that are needed to, like, take care of cats if it works and, like, continues to, can people continue to participate in it.
Correct.
Why do other methods do you think don't work? I mean,
sure. So, methods like catch and kill, we're killing our cats, but not necessarily decreasing the population, because there will be new cats that'll come around, and those new cats will have more kittens. And so eliminating a cat from the population will not overall decrease our population of animals. So that method generally does not, you know, that's a method that doesn't work. Adoption, not all feral cats can live in homes. An animal that lives outside may not be good in an indoor setting. Some outdoor cats thrive in those outdoor colonies. So that is one of the methods that, you know, while it does work for the cats that are definitely socialized and able to live in homes, sometimes a cat doesn't want to live inside. Adoption, relocation is another. That could cause stress, like we talked about, on an animal if they're relocated. That's not their home. And so keeping them in the homes and the areas that they are typically in will reduce that stress. And then a lot of cats live in sanctuaries, but sanctuaries aren't always work either, in the same sense that it doesn't stabilize the population. It does increase the population. And there aren't always enough sanctuaries in the area. We could always have sanctuaries, but cats continue to increase in population. And then our outdoor cats will suffer from the stress and disease of living inside a home. So that's some of the other methods that don't work. And spay and neutering is typically the best method that will work for the overall population of animals.
So would you say that it does work for everyone?
Cats have lived outdoors for a very long time, long before they lived indoors. So I would say by stabilizing the population humanely, it'll improve the cats' lives, it'll save taxpayer dollars, it'll address the neighbors' concerns, it'll help the entire community reach a solution that benefits everyone. So I would definitely say that it does work for everyone.
So tell me a little bit about the Redinger Clinic and how it relates to Halifax.
Sure. So for the Redinger Clinic, that is definitely, they spay and neuter your animals at a very minimal cost. And for the month of February, actually, we have a Get Your Female Cat Fix, and we do run through PetSmart Charities. We have grants that are given to us, and we're able to reduce the cost even further for those for the animals. So for the month of February, we do have Your Female Cat Fix for $20. And for that promotion, it's called Beat the Heat. So if you call the Redinger Clinic and mention the Beat the Heat promotion, it'll only be $20 to spay your
female. Can you tell me a little bit about this name, Beat the Heat? What's that a reference to?
Basically, beating the heat of...
Because they're more active and more likely to reproduce during certain periods?
Yep, so Beat the Heat, we're going to beat the cats having more kittens go ahead and have your female cat fixed.
They call it kitten season around here, like in the spring where there's like lots of kittens, you know.
Correct. So the cats we're trying to beat the cats being in heat and reduce the population of the kittens and the...
So any age bracket for your female kitten?
I would definitely recommend checking with your vet as far as what age would be appropriate to spay or neuter. And your vet would definitely have the best recommendations on that. I know when they're, like we had talked about, when they are during the TNR, the rabies vaccine can be given as early as 4 months, even if it's a TNR cat. So having your animal vaccinated, it's Florida state law that all animals are vaccinated. And so having that yearly vaccine is really important as well. So that's an opportunity for them to not only during the TNR process have the vaccine, but also be spay or neutered as well.
So this clinic is located...
it's on Mason Avenue.
Okay.
And we are open during normal business hours, you can definitely give us a call and mention the ad, and we would be more than happy to. Now, if we can't meet, we do, that is up to 300 appointments. So up to the 300 pets. Now, if we exceed that, which sometimes we do, we put you on a waiting list because there are always the opportunities for no-shows or cancellations. So we always make sure that we put you on a wait list. And if we...
So you go there with your animal, and then how long can you expect to wait? Or
yeah, so you can go there with your animal, drop off your cat, and then they'll give you a call when the cat is...
Do you know how long the process takes?
I don't know offhand the hours of the process, but I know typically you go and drop off your animal in the morning, and then they'll call you when everything is all set,
Covering.
And you can come back and pick your animal up.
Cool. Any other promotions, like you guys, I know you have some other stuff during the year. Do you want to talk about
it? Yeah, anything? We have, as far as spaying, neutering, or just event
anything.
Programs. Coming up, we do have our annual mutt strut, where the dogs are allowed to go on the beach. And that is something we actually just opened up the campaign for. So definitely you can check us out on Facebook. We post regular updates on spaying, neutering. We post updates on events that we have coming up. And it's the mutt strut on the beach, we recommend if you want to have a team, teams from different areas. So whether it be, you know, local group of soccer team that
right.
wants to have a run on the beach, or somebody else wants to set up a different team. We recommend that you set up your own team and
you can fundraise for Halifax.
Absolutely. So those specific teams can fundraise, or you can, just as an individual, you can sign up. And it is $25 to sign up, and that includes a t-shirt and a beverage of your choice.
Do you know if you guys are doing, you did something with pit bulls and like Primp Your Pit or
so
something?
So we do have a Primp Your Pit promotion that we usually do, as well as a Precious Not Parents.
Oh yeah.
And those are not released at the time yet, but those
right.
are something that we do for Pets Don't Charities.
What about if somebody is interested in adoption or...
Sure.
something, I don't know, donating to Halifax?
Sure.
What's that?
So on our website, you definitely, it's halifaxhumanesociety.org, and there is the animals that are up for adoption are listed on our website. And then also anything.
We see dogs and cats, but you often have other things.
Animals too, yeah. actually, just yesterday we had some ferrets come in. So there are animals. We recommend you check our site daily because we are continuously updating it.
Can I see pictures of like potential?
Absolutely. There's pictures of dogs and cats, but then we have an other animals section on our website, and you can check out the other animals that we have and the photos and a little bit about them. There are different programs also listed on our website. We do have the Prison Pups and Pals, where some of our dogs are sent to prison for 7 weeks, and they go and they're taught different behaviors, sit, stand, walk. And that is a great program that we have as well. So there's several different programs you can check out on there.
I was considering adopting, but I wanted some guidance about what pet would be right for my family. Do you guys provide any kind of
advice? Yeah, we do different programs that we have in place for you and your family to see what animals
like the breed or whatever.
Yeah, Meet Your Match.
Oh, okay.
So the Meet Your Match program will definitely help you and your family find out what is best for.
And I sometimes see that people have like donated pet food or toys.
Absolutely.
Or whatever. Are you guys open to that sort
yes,
of thing?
Yes, absolutely. We're always getting folks that give us a call and let us know, hey, we have this, we ran this fundraiser for you. We want to donate some pet food. Actually, I had a young girl message us on Facebook and send us a message that she had for her birthday party. She, instead of receiving presents, she asked for donations for
wow.
dogs and cats, and she received a huge amount of dog food that she's actually
That's
going to be
cool.
bringing us today. So we love when there's different creative ways of you want to fundraise with us,
right.
and we definitely are willing to work with you and helping out with whatever you need.
So Amber, give me contact information for Halifax and then the clinic.
Sure. So the clinic's number is 386-310-4935, and they're on Mason Avenue. You can definitely check them out on Facebook, but we can also always direct you. And our Facebook is up there as well. It has all the information on it. But our website is halifaxhumanesociety.org. And there is an email, info@halifaxhumanesociety.org. So if you're interested in just sending us an email, you need some more information, that is the form of information, the email, that would be best. And if you would like to give us a call, you certainly can. However, I would recommend if you're going to do the promotion to call the Redinger Clinic first.
So Amber, if somebody needs to call Halifax, what's the phone number there?
Sure. So the number for Halifax Humane Society is 386-274-4703. And that is the best number of contact if you'd like to talk to the shelter about adoptions or programs that we have. The Redinger Clinic's number is the 386-310-4935.
And that's if you want to schedule the surgeries.
And be sure if you're looking for the spay program for the animals in February, the Beat the Heat promotion, the best thing to do is make sure that you mention the promotion so that they know. And like we had said, it's up to the first 300 animals that call in. So if you're within that 300, you absolutely will get the promotion. If you're outside, we do recommend we'll put you on our wait list. You still can get your animal spayed or neutered. It just may not be within the guidelines of that promotion. But also keep an eye out. We always post our promotions on our Facebook page, so that's definitely something to look out for as well.
Thanks, Amber, for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
Once again, I'm Wendy Jackson from the city of Deltona, and thank you for watching Best Friends on Four Legs.